whenever I talk about the importance of e-commerce, actually e-commerce is a part of ICT. And whole topic is about knowledge economy. So we are moving from knowledge management to knowledge economy. And as my friend before, he said that or the nature of social science, there is no specific definition. Knowledge economy simply is how we use the knowledge to create value. And if we back to the history, the human being is starting with in economic evolution. We have the primitive economy. It was based on hunting and gathering food, hunting animals and gathering food. And then there is a knowledge created. And this is knowledge created in hunting and gathering food, or the primitive economy introduced the agricultural economy, agricultural revolution. And there is a knowledge also created in agricultural revolution, which is introduced to industrial revolution that took place in Great Britain, the place we are here, in 17th century, I think. Then there is a knowledge created and developed it, introduced to the information economy. We call it last time information technology. And after 2000, we have a new concept of the economy is going until now, which is knowledge economy is based on information and communication technology. So part of information and communication technology is e-commerce. So e-commerce has changed the method of working through offering new opportunities. As you know, everybody is dealing with online transaction from credit card to everything. So all these are application of ICT. And this is the outcome of technological progress. If you ask me why European Union have a lot of problem now, simple to me, there is no technological progress. Great Britain introduces an industrial revolution, but now is not, it has no good position in industrialization or even in knowledge economy. And the lack is the lack of technological progress, which is creating new technology. Creating new technology is need also human factor, which is we call it human capital, because people will make the difference. People will create the technology, and people will use the technology. So all the problem we are seeing now, from financial crisis to everything, it has a relation with human factor, which is human capital. That is a declining of human skills everywhere. And only if you look to East Asia, why they are progressing very fast, especially Korea, because of the human factor. They have very disciplined and high-skilled people who are using at least the technology or producing the technology in case of Japan and Korea, South Korea. And surprisingly, Iran is the only country in Middle East has research and development. Surprisingly, if you look to all the Middle East countries, you cannot find a good research. Although they have a problem of language, because they are not familiar with English, but they have a lot of research. They are developing a lot of technology. And when I supervise this student, she knows, even she doesn't know the basic of research technicalities. And she did her MBA in Canada. Then with my technical assistant, she came with very wonderful thesis. And this is part of the, this is one of the paper. So these are stages of e-commerce, readiness, intensity, and impact. And these are Middle East internet users, but it's not necessary that if you are using high internet, it means that you are using it in productive site. Maybe there are people using who high internet usage, but unfortunately for entertainment or Arabic Spring only, but not creating technology or developing the research or doing whatever. So this is a profile of Iranian small and medium enterprises. Normally, the small and medium enterprises are the backbone of most of the economy. If you come to Malaysia, it's 90% also. And then the success of any country is based on the success of small and medium enterprises. If you look back to Japan, all the Japanese companies are associated with family names, starting from home to factory to multinational company. I have a good experience in 1999 when I was in Sapporo, north of Japan in Hokkaido. Then I was sitting in the TV, then one Japanese friend told me, "This is Mr. Sony." Then I told him, "Really, he's a person?" He said, "Yes, he's a person." Then I discovered that Suzuki, Sony, Nissan, whoever. Okay, so the small and medium enterprises are very important to hold the economy. It can be transformed to large companies, as we see in Japanese case, and also in Korean case. Why Korean has succeed? They have LG, Samsung, all these companies also. Behind them are families starting from home to factories. So the success of the Iranian economy is based on how they built their SMEs, especially in terms of using the ICT or e-commerce. Okay, these are also one of the most important generator of employment chances, small and medium enterprises of the country. If I look to Malaysia, they have 10 million who are employed. Out of 2 million, we have only 1 million working in the government, and 9 million are working in SMEs and multinational companies. So SMEs are very important in generating the sources of employment of every country. Then this is the background of economic growth. Actually, we talk here about a very important issue. I return back to our distinguished professor who talked about the end of growth. Okay, the end of growth actually is a real story. It has two dimensions. We have actually sustainability can be associated with environment or associated with technology. So the end of growth is in terms of total factor productivity here, which is a combined contribution of the quality of inputs, physical capital, human capital, whatever input I use. And what's one of the most important, some countries they have no progress. Behind that is human capital development. Normally we account for physical assets. We'll never forget talk about intellectual assets. The knowledge and that is transferring skills. This will make the difference in the companies in the countries. Why Japan is developing very fast. Japan is a country, has no resources, it came from the war, a divided country, and then luckily, those who joined the workforce, they have military background, they were very disciplined. Then through the help of this discipline, human capital developed new technology. Maybe in the beginning they adapted from the West countries. As we know in the history, what has been achieved in Great Britain, it has been achieved in 70 years in US, but when it comes to Japan, it's in 30 years and so on. So the difference is the difference in human capital and the technological progress will show that the growth will be and will continue. You want to continue, you have to have a technological progress, and this is one of the most important factor contributed to the collapse of Soviet Union in 1990s. Because Soviet Union bring many countries with huge resources, they develop very industrialization, but they fail to progress of technological progress, which is a total factor productivity. Okay? So in developed and developing countries, they have different progress. And unfortunately, the developed countries now they have problem. They are not able to progress. And those claim as developing countries, they are progressing. Again, the difference is different how to create the technology and also based on human factor. You can look to the case of South Korea and China, although there is no quality, but still there are people who have the skills to use the technology. All the Apple production is in China. Not because it's cheap, as they say, but there are people that have the skills, they know how to make it faster. This is a reality. So this is the human capital that I talk about it. And then if we talk about the productivity of these companies, actually we have two types of economic growth. One is productivity driven and one is input driven. If you have a technological progress, then you have a productivity driven. If you have no technological progress, you are only using the input to produce output, is only input driven, there is no progress. And this is the case of most of East Asian countries except Japan and South Korea. If you want to know this, look to the companies who are competing internationally. Most of them are Japanese or Korean. None of even the European countries and other East Asian countries, they have multinational companies to compete. These are the problems facing the small and medium enterprises in Iran. Availability of fund, and if the fund is available, the money. Also availability of right human capital, because these small companies are run by family owners who have no experience in the business they are doing. So a lot of money will be used. As a result of that, low productivity and low total factor productivity or technological progress. So there are many literature. I don't know if we have time to share or not. And these all the theories. If you look here, the most important is the technological progress. Productivity, management, leadership, this come under the knowledge economy, creativity, best practices, innovation. We have all these, then we'll be having high productivity, so higher quality, product, excellent service, lower cost, customer satisfaction, sustainable economic growth. Okay? Otherwise, we have input driven, using input to produce output, greater wealth, higher standard of living. There are many countries who are enjoying higher standard of living, but they have no progress. They have no progress. So this here is productivity driven based on technological progress. Here is input driven by using only the resources. Here we ensure the sustainability of our environment, because the less resources you use, it means that lower pollution. And here will be much pollution, and most of the country, they are following the traditional method of development, pollute now and clean up later. And most of the disagreement in WTO because of major countries like US, China, and India, they are not able to implement the international agreement of environmental issues, Kyoto Protocol or whatever. Okay, so this is the theory behind productivity is developed by Solo, and we have something called Solo model. And he discovers the total factor productivity, and he simply says that after we account for physical inputs and output, there is something else, which is based on the quality of inputs. They call it Solo residuals, and they call it the measure of our ignorance. We ignore how the differences between nations, we ignore how the technology gap has come. Maybe due to human capital, maybe due to physical quality of human capital, or quality of physical capital, or quality of any input. So when we talk about the quality, then we talk about Solo residual, or total factor productivity, or technological progress. I call it the measure of our ignorance. And also, there is a productivity paradox, especially in US, regardless the investment in ICT, but it has no immediate effect. And maybe because of investment, it need to take time, or maybe due to human capital who are involved in this. So regardless of, Solo also says that regardless the investment in ICT in US, but we never see that in productivity. There are many reasons, many explanations. I don't think I have time to go through. You have the complete paper. You can go through and see what are the scholars in the literature say, what are the sources of productivity products. There are many literature here, including my own research. This is the first time to present a co-author. All the time I was a sole author, and I have from 2006 up to 2012 a lot of paper about green productivity or knowledge economy, ICT, and human capital. And I have one about intellectual capital is in progress, in under review. So the most important here is a spillover effect. What does mean by spillover effect? If you talk about ICT or we talk about foreign direct investment, we expect to technology transfer and human capital skill upgrading. So if you look to the foreign direct investment or ICT, how this ICT or foreign direct investment upgrades the skills of the local people or transfer technology to local companies. There are many theories about productivity. The most important one is the extensive theory we are using here. I mean, we have talking about output as a function of inputs. When we talk about intensive growth theory, we talk about labor productivity and capital productivity. We have few papers about this, but are not going to be presented here. So the paper here about extensive growth theory, which is based on the theory of output. So there are many also literature, and the details are in the paper. If you are interested, you can find it. This is the labor productivity, which is output per unit, and we have the capital productivity, is how much amount of output produced by unit of capital. And this is the main theory, is the gap in the world accounting theory. It based on indicators. And some people are using econometrics, they have no indicators. So this study closed both gaps. We have a statistical analysis to close the gap in the major model, and also we have econometric analysis. Then by doing so, we have both parameters, and we have also productivity indicators. Okay, so this is a theory about, and this is a model here. Simply, by using mathematical model, I what we tell you, we have the output as a function of capital. Here is physical capital, and this is the human capital, and we have the material. This is the labor force, and this is the skilled labor. Okay, and then we have the IC, e-commerce. These all are the measure of IC. If you look to input to produce output, this is the input driven. If you look to the quality of all these inputs, this is the total factor productivity, which is the solo residual or the technological progress. And there are many hypotheses attached to this. And this is a mathematical model, is very important here. We have the gross value of output as a function of, this is a very important factor, which is the solo residual, based on the quality of all these inputs. Output based on the quantity of inputs, okay? We have the labor, we have capital, we have material, we have human capital, and we have EC, okay? This is a econometric analysis. This model has a problem. There are no indicators. We have the parameters. And the original model has a problem of not having this. So we combine them together. This is a residual as a function of capital output minus all this. So we have all the, we will calculate the TAP, and we will calculate the capital, labor, and material, and all this. So these are the details, econometric estimation, and then productivity indicators. We have a formula also for calculating the capital stock. One of the most significant contribution of this paper, we calculate the capital stock through this formula. And these are the source of data, actually is a 2 years data for 12,000 companies. And then we have sample size of 378 Iranian manufacturing SMEs. And these for 2 years, and a panel estimation. And these are the measure of.
Can I just clarify something? You only studied manufacturing firms, no firms in other
sectors? No, not all. Because here this is more an idiom, manufacturing companies. If you go to the surface, you go to construction, there are many, many. But actually, it's very difficult to take all of them. One of the constraints is the data, because we especially the e-commerce data.
So do you think there's any limitation in generalizing to all small firms from studying only manufacturing?
Yeah, they are different. Those who involve in surface, I believe they have most good story about knowledge economy, because knowledge economy is associated with the surface more than manufacturing. Maybe my next PhD student can do that. I don't know, I can get it or not. Then we use the eViews. It's a very famous software in econometric analysis, and then these are all the testing Hausmann test, heteroscedasticity. We don't have problem of co-integration because you have only 2 years. We the unit root and co-integration is not big issue here. It's normally for long data. We have only 2 years and plenty later, and cross-sectional later also. These are the results and discussion. These are the parameters. Okay, and this is a test for every variable. Then we come to the conclusion, e-sailing and using internet to offer information has positive impact indicated by high significance of coefficient of EC. A small and medium enterprises using e-sailing showed almost 47% growth, and a small and medium enterprises using internet offering information showed almost 17.6% of growth output. It means that using the e-commerce or using online application will help to increase output. Number of employees using internet had positive also impact indicated by higher significant coefficient, which is only accounted for 1.4%. Why is 1.4%? Because people, they lack skills. The human factor here is behind all the problem of low productivity. It's not the e-commerce application. So the human skills must matching with the technology. If we don't have the right human skills, the technology cannot work. Technology is only facilitator, and human will make the change by using the technology. So the Iranian, I can conclude from here, the Iranian small and medium enterprises are lacking skill. As I have mentioned before, they are family owners. They have no knowledge of the business, and also they don't have the right skills to use the technology. So this contribution is only 1.4%. If you look to the ICT contribution, 47.8 and 17.6 for internet usage. Number of employees using computer, e-buying, and using also internet to gather information did not have any significant impact. These are just the justifications. We don't have much time. And these are the components of the model: labor, capital, physical capital, materials, human capital, had positive impact on gross value of output. And the coefficient of this variable shows that their significant positive impact are very similar in size using all of 6 e-commerce measures. And the limitation of this study, all this data is proxy. We cannot only say that e-commerce, e-buying or e-selling or using internet or computer. And this is a problem of a new economy. You cannot get the right and good proxy to measure the human capital and ICT. By this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you very much for attention.